Hello, my name is Gislin Dagnelie. I'm an associate professor of ophthalmology, and I work in the Alliance Vision Research and Rehabilitation Center, which is part of the Johns Hopkins Wilmer Eye Institute. I'm a researcher. I do see patients, but only for research purposes. And most of my research works with patients who have very, very little vision left. They cannot see letters on the chart. They can see movement. They may be able to see where light is coming from and whether it's day or night. Normally, they would walk around with a cane or a guide dog. And so these people, whom we normally think of as completely blind, in fact have a little bit of vision, and they can still use that. So part of my research is actually aimed at how do we measure that kind of vision? You can't put them in front of a letter chart because they can't see any letters. But we have other types of cards that we hold in front of them with black and white on them to see the difference between those. And we have also designed a number of assessments, tests where we can have them perform standardized activities like see an object in front of the table and pick it up. We also look at how we can restore vision in people who are completely blind, and that's a completely different area of my research. There are now two ways in which we can restore vision in people who were completely blind. One is called a retinal implant, and there is the Argus 2 that has been on the market for a few years. We've implanted that in people who have retinitis pigmentosa, or other diseases of the rods and cones, where they lose all their vision, and we can stimulate the secondary cells just like you would do in a cochlear implant. The other type of implant is in the visual cortex. It doesn't exist yet, but we hope that in a few years we'll be doing that in combination with a number of centers around the country. So you can see that even for people who have no useful vision left by most standards, there's actually still some vision, and they can still use it to orient themselves, to walk around, and to see where they are in their environment. If you know people who have this kind of vision, I'd be happy to consider them for my research. We can always use volunteers, and we're very grateful for their contributions that make this work possible.